From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
Hi there, I'm Norm Karkos. A man from Bloomington is being held at the York County Jail after a seven-hour standoff at his home on Route 25.
29-year-old Kevin Ridland surrendered around 2:30 this morning. He's now charged with criminal threatening and criminal mischief. Public safety spokesman Steve McCausland says Ridland had been drinking and threatening his girlfriend last night. She was able to leave and call police. McCausland says about 30 state troopers responded. It was a negotiator who was finally able to talk Ridland into surrendering.
Meanwhile, the Westbrook City Council gave final unanimous approval to set a set of guidelines, we should say, governing when, where, and how businesses with the nude entertainment can operate. The rules laid down last night are retroactive to late September when the nude club Dreamers Cabaret was shut down. The city says it closed the club the day after it opened because of fire code violations. The club is still closed. Some of the new restrictions include that nude establishments have to be closed by 1 a.m. They cannot serve alcohol, and touching is not allowed. There are also only allowed in industrial zone areas on Warren Avenue as well. Election day is indeed finally here.
And the biggest race, no doubt, on the ballot is to decide who will become Maine's next governor. Our News 8's Dave Gothrow has more.
Well, the governor's race still very much up for grabs, although it looks like independent Elliot Cutler or Democrat Libby Mitchell will have to garner at least 40% of the vote, as that's where Republican Paula Page has been polling. Now, a day before the election, Mr. Cutler was on a tour of downtown Kennebunk trying to convince voters that he is most likely to beat LePage. He thinks the race has narrowed to the two of them, but Democrat Libby Mitchell and her supporters are far from conceding defeat. Mitchell says her experience and record of accomplishment is helping her gain voters. LePage, who has been the front runner throughout the campaign, told supporters in Old Orchard Beach last night to make sure they get out and vote today. And again, the other two candidates, independents Kevin Scott and Sean Moody, are on the ballot but have remained fairly low-key in these days before the election. And later on today, all of the candidates will go out and cast their own ballots before meeting last-minute undecideds, and trying to convince them to vote for their cause. And we'll have the most complete coverage and analysis all day long and all night long on News 8 and WMTW.com. For now, in Portland, I'm Dave Guthrow for News 8 Now.
David, thank you. Also, three statewide questions and two other statewide races that voters will weigh in on today as well.
Candidates for Maine's 1st District congressional seat are focusing on undecided voters. Democratic incumbent Shelley Pingree greeted workers at Royal Bean Coffee Shop in Yarmouth. Republican Dean Scottress, he talked with customers at the Maine Diner in Wells.
And Republican Jason Levesque of Auburn is taking on incumbent Mike Michaud for Maine's 2nd congressional seat. Political analysts say that Levesque is Michaud's toughest competition since he took office 8 years ago, thanks to anti-Democrat sentiment all across the country and Tea Party activism.
As he said, there are three statewide referendum questions on the ballot. Question one asks whether voters want to allow a casino with table games and slot machines to be built in Oxford County. Question two asks for approval of a $5 million bond to increase access to dental care in Maine. And question three is a $9.75 million bond issue about land conservation and waterfront and state park preservation.
All right, that's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Make sure you stay with us. Your latest forecast and sports highlights are coming right up. We'll be right back.